How's it going, internets? I hope you're having an amazing day today. It's time to get creative, it's time to get imaginative, and it's time to get inspired. And today's inspiration comes from the Hildebrandt Brothers. And if you're not familiar with them, why aren't you? They're amazing. They're so iconic and classic. I'll just throw a couple images here from some of their paintings and illustrations, and oh my goodness, it's just beautiful. I feel like you could just like walk right into there. There's so much realism and so much fantasy in there as well, and it's such a nice play back and forth between the two. If you're not familiar with their work, I'll throw some stuff in the links below. Definitely check it out. And then let me pull down, get to one of these. Yeah, I thought that image was really cool. Even just the way that this the skin looks on that, it's like a sea monster kind of thing. It's really cool. And you got the bug guy. Oh, just great worlds and such great atmosphere and composition to their shots and everything. I found an older interview with them, and I thought I'd share some excerpts from that that I thought were really poignant and great to share with you guys. At least I felt compelled to do so with you guys. So I'm not sure that all my inspiration comes from somewhere other than my own burning desire to do art. For sure, part of it comes from people in my life, part of it comes from what's occurring in my life at any given time, part of it comes from what's occurring in the world. But I think that's great that it's not, and I mean, we're talking, we're getting inspired and everything here, but like the real desire and everything just comes from within. It's true, it's deep down. And you know, we can look at this stuff, we can look, but if you don't do anything with it, you know, that inspiration just falls flat. So always be aware, always be looking around for things that you can get ideas from, but really have that passion deep within. And then we didn't choose art, art chose us. It was as if we were born to do art. My mom told me we started it to draw at 3 and just never stopped. We were obsessed with it. I think that's such a great mindset to have of just, you know, from the age, whenever that bug hits you, that this is what you want to do, whatever it is that you're passionate about, don't ever stop. If you're doing something where you don't feel like it's true to who you are, maybe you're doing the wrong thing. Maybe you readjust and see, and you know, you got to do whatever you got to do to put food on the table, but see where you can feel that passion, that burning desire. Most artists live in their heads. Their head is filled with ideas about art and not much else. And I think that's true. Some days I notice that I'm just like oblivious to other things. Like someone will be talking to me, but I'll just be thinking about a new shot I want to do or a new illustration I want to do or something. And I'll just like, I'll be there. I'll be looking at them. I hear the words they're saying, but I'm so far off thinking about something else. I wonder if that happens to you, let me know down in the comments below as well. And then the last part was, live your art every second of your life. Never settle with your art. Continuously push yourself to do what you're sure you can't do. And once you've mastered what you're sure you cannot master, go further. I think that's great. It just talks about that approach to not be afraid to fail. Go ahead and push yourself and push yourself until you succeed. And then once you've hit that new high standard for yourself, go further. I think that's such a great, great way to think about art and not to worry about, you know, any sort of failure, to continue to push yourself and never settle with where you're at. And then let's just take another quick look just at, oh man, they did some Lord of the Rings art that's just magnificent. I just love their style. It's got almost like a cartoony feel to it as well, but still that sense of realism and that sense of fantasy that's just great. One of my favorites, that's for sure. I love this. I love these worlds, this like almost like a fungal or a like sporish type surrounding. It's so cool. Oh, I could get lost and stare at this all day, but we're gonna do some animation. So if you're not familiar with that, what we do is we give ourselves anywhere from 45 minutes to about 2 hours and 48 frames and see what we can come up with. And this rig today is a Dota 2 sniper rig, and I will link it. It's a free rig that you can grab. I will throw the information down below, and we're going to be using Maya 2014. And without further ado, let's get started. First thing we're going to do is we're going to turn off our textures here And let's create a base for which to go with. And I have kind of two ideas with this shot. I want to try posing out the first one and see if we can get that to work. I was thinking we could do something where we have the, like, rifle slung behind the head and the arms kind of up over it. But I'm not sure if that's going to work with this rig. So the other one would just be kind of where you got it holding against your shoulder and, you know, the typical kind of, you know, rifleman pose with the rifle in the hand and resting against the shoulder. So we'll see if we can get the other one, because I think that would be a more fun pose to try out. But it just might not work because of the size of the gun, and if we get too much deformation going on in... get too much deformation in the arms, I think is what I was trying to say. And see, this is what I'm talking about here too, like he was talking about before, about getting distracted with your art. Let's see, X. Is that sometimes I notice even on these ones, I'm trying to illustrate a point or talk about a point, and I get lost because I'm thinking about how I want to approach something. Yeah, we'll have to. Adjust this because it's constrained to that shoulder air movement, I think, too. So we'll have to play a little bit of. What do they call it? What's the name of that? Or you animate and then you counter animation, I believe. That's what they call it. We'll be able to do this idea. I think it'll work well enough. Just have to figure out a good angle to go here with that, so that we can show off a good silhouette still. Thanks again for all of the subscribes and the likes on all the videos lately. Really appreciate it. You guys are awesome and amazing. And don't forget to comment down below if there's other things you'd like to see, or if you have different ideas, or if you end up using one of these rigs in a shot of your own. Just do, you know, the rotate X, the rotate Y, and the rotate Z separate, so that I make sure that I'm not having to key everything, but for this one it's going to be a little bit trickier, so we're definitely going to want to. It's too broken. Maybe it's coming from the shoulder here. Maybe the gun itself, we need to pull it forward. Where's the neck? Let's pull the neck down and pull the head up. So you get that nice sense of weight that's weighing down the neck a little bit more. We just don't want that intersection in the hand, so we have to kind of do some counter animation for a little while. Since the way this is constrained here. And I want that shoulder here. I don't want to do it on the translates, even though I think that would be easier a little bit. Once we get all this nailed down, then the rest of it should be pretty straightforward. It's just going to be this initial pose that's going to be a little bit back and forth and tricky to get settled in here. Okay, let's see if we can get into those fingers so we can get those. Nope. Okay, gotta do something so that it's not intersecting through there. Let's lift that hand up. Yeah, maybe drag those fingers down a little bit. There was one that was a. We'd separate those fingers a little bit more, but that's okay. Hang that. Tip doesn't work. Okay. think we had a problem with that on the previous one, where the tips of the fingers weren't working right. See, we're just getting a little bit of a strange deformer, so we'll go ahead and kind of leave it like that. That's okay. And let's go ahead and see if we can't pull this cape down a little bit. Let's go ahead and spread the feet out even a little bit more. Pull the hips down a little bit more. Turn our textures on, see how that looks. Ooh, for some reason we assigned a texture to this, huh? Assign new material, a Lambert, that looks funny. Okay. And turn the, is there a way to turn just the, do a little bit of beard hang. Let's see if we can get. Let's go ahead and save our file. Control S. I actually already saved a with the name and everything, so I'm just saving it. Don't forget to save multiple versions and save often. Suck and thrust. What's that? Okay, let's thrust it forward then. Do it with that. Let's have it hang down, because it seems, I want this to feel like there's some weight here, for some reason that he's doing that, so. Save it here one more time. And let's turn our textures off. Let's grab everything. Make sure we turned everything off except for our NURB curves, NURB surfaces, and our polygons. And let's short down to 48 frames. Now that we got our starting pose here. And set that. For some reason it's 0.8 and we want it to be at 1. So I want to grab everything. set that at 1. And let's get started with our walk. Okay. First thing we want to do is set down the foundation, which is going to be the feet and the hips. So let's go ahead and grab that foot controller there. And let's stick with 12s for now. We might slow it down a little bit. Some knee controllers here, just to make sure we pull those forward there. That foot and set it at 36 and pull that forward to 48 and pull those forward. And let's go into our window, animation editor is graph editor, translate Z. Let's even that out. That's going to be the left to right movement on the hips here. And we'll even that up so that's a consistent amount of movement. Okay, and let's go ahead and watch that. Hips could be a little bit further forward. So let's see. Okay, I feel like they might be a little too far pushed out. So let's go ahead and pull that in and pull that in. Because we can have some widespread steps, but those are a little too widespread, so let's translate X. We just want to delete anything else that we have there. And this one, translate X. Do not grab everything, translate X. Delete that, so it's back inward. Okay, let's see. Okay, it's the. Now I got some good foundation here, so let's stop that and save our file here. Let's get a little bit of up and down on the passing position on those feet. So we'll raise that up, and we can have these be low steps and drag it back. And zero out that, and zero out that. Set that. Just a little bit of a mesh deformer on the side here. See that? Nothing we can really get in and fix with that right now. And we'll rotate it back. And we'll land that out. So let's see. And I think we're going to pull those, even those up a little bit at least. Here, set one hip there, and raise it up, and drag it back, and set that, and raise it up, and drag it back. So let's see here. Okay, Now, I need to get some up and down going in those hips to get some weight moving. And raise it up. And push it down. And raise it up. And push it down. And raise it up. And push it down. And raise it up. Y, and let's tone those up and downs a little bit less, squash them up a little bit more, and pull that down. Now sometimes I try to do this in most of my videos, I try to recognize what might be a more difficult area in our shot, and that's going to be the counter animation by getting a little bit of keep alive in that hand by keeping that gun where it is, so that's going to be kind of okay. And let's get a little bit of lean in the hips over that one and over that one and over that one and over that one and that way. Let's see. It's a little too much translate X, so let's scale that back. Maybe we'll give it to like a 4 or around there. And let's raise it up, and then let's make sure that we zero it back out here. So let's go ahead and watch that now. Okay, and let's go ahead and save our file here. And let's do a little bit of rotate Z here, so there's a little bit of lean. And a little bit of lean there. And a little bit of lean there. And a little bit back. Let's go ahead and watch that. Okay, that's going to be a little too much. But remember, we're going to offset it in the chest too, so we still want to have some in here. And let's go ahead and watch that now. And let's go ahead and rotate Y so it's favoring that front step there. And that one there. That one there. And that one there. And that one there. So let's go ahead and see. Okay, a little too little much than I needed. So let's go ahead and more than I needed. Something like that. And pull that over, just that. Okay, let's go ahead and watch it now. Okay, and now this should be the torso, so go ahead and rotate that to favor the other side here, so that there's a little bit of twist. It's one leg's favoring, the opposite hand's being favored forward. The opposite shoulder. It's depending on the walk, you might not have the hands in those positions. And let's go ahead and even those out a little bit more, because right now it would be favoring the other side here. So let's go ahead and check that now. Let's see here. And let's do a little bit of this, so there's a little bit of stretch on that side and squash over here, and vice versa. And it might be a little too much, so maybe we'll tone it back. Yeah, let's zero that out again. So let's see here. Okay. Let's go ahead and tone that down in the chest, that rotates side to side there. Okay, so let's go ahead and watch that now. And Do a little bit of compression in there. And that'll be by having the chest rotate in X one direction while the hips rotate in X the other direction. So that'll give us that sense of like a belly kind of a feel there. By adding that compression in there. Feels like there's a little too much rotate X on the hips and not enough on the chest. So let's go ahead and tone the hips down a little bit and accentuate the rotate on the torso. Remember, this is just kind of an accent to it. We don't need it to feel. There we go. Let's get a little bit of the air. And let's go ahead and do a little bit of rotate X down there. And up. It's probably going to be too much, but again, we're going to offset it by the rotation of the head from the neck, and then we'll probably scale it back down as well, but we're just laying in the foundation for doing that stuff, so let's go ahead and check that here, and let's just watch it with just the neck. Okay, that's a little bit too much, but let's get that up, so we'll go and then down, and then up, and then down. And then we'll probably delay this about two frames too so that it hits a little bit behind what the chest is doing. So that'll give us some differentiation in timing. This to come from the neck, since that gun's gonna be weighted on there. I feel like that neck would have a good amount of movement. So let's scale up the neck here and see if that helps us out a little bit as well. Let's see. Okay, so let's grab the head and the neck, and let's delay those a frame. Let's grab the head and we'll delay that a frame as well. Now let's go ahead and watch that. Okay, a little too much, so I'll have to scale it back again. That's okay, a little bit of tweak here, tweak there till you get it just right. Okay, let's go ahead and watch it. And let's let's go ahead and scale back the neck as well. Okay, let's go ahead and watch that now. Maybe a little less on the head. Let's see here. Yeah, let's tone down the neck again. Too much, but then we'll figure it out. That feels pretty good. And then let's go ahead and do a little bit of rotate this way, this way, this way, and this way, back again. So there's a little bit of sway side to side in the head here. Let's go ahead and even this out a little bit more because it doesn't feel like there's a good amount of left and right sway. It feels like it was favoring one side over the other, so that's a little more even. And let's also do it in the head here. Yeah, because see, like we didn't even get over flipping it to the other direction. So let's go ahead. Feels pretty good, but I think we want to do a little bit of rotate Y there as well. So let's go ahead, just so there's an angle at which the head is going there. And that's 12 from that. That'd be 16, right? Too much, so I'll scale it back. And let's do a little bit in the head as well. Scale that down a little bit more, and we'll delay that a frame as well. Okay. I feel like we pulled everything out of it though now, so let's see if we can't put a little more back in there. There we go. We don't want to squash all the movement out of it. Yeah, let's turn our textures on just so we can see that here real quick. Let's watch it now. Okay, maybe a little more side to side and a little less up and down. Like I said, up and down. Let's see here. Sometimes you gotta throw those textures on to see them go. Okay, and then let's go ahead and do some here. I wish there was a way to kind of angle that, because it's always like perpetually a little bit swayed. If it was straight down, that would be a little bit easier. So let's see if we can't get that a little bit better. Okay. And rotate Z. Scale it back here a little bit. And let's watch that now. Okay, now let's take what we have here and let's delay it 2 frames. Just scale it all the way down a little bit more. Yeah, maybe we'll delay it one more frame. Let's try that. Let's do a little bit more, rotate Y on that torso here. Let's do a little bit of bounce here. Up here. Actually, let's just make sure that we get the right up and down. Up and down. delay that like two frames as well, so that hits a little bit behind. We just want to do some more stuff to add some texture to our timing and everything, so it's not so even. And let's do a little bit less up and a little bit more down. Just one frame. Let's go ahead and watch that Let's go ahead and do a little bit. Now what if I just do up and down? Raise and lower. Normally I would do the shoulder with rotate instead of translate, but since I'm gonna have to do some offsetting and everything, I think that's what I'll end up doing instead. I think it'll feel a little better. It'll be easier to manage. Not necessarily that we always go for easy, but just because I want to be able to, that, and let's watch that. And let's get the other clap going here then. So that's 4 and 10 60. Oh, you know what? Hold on. Make sure that we just stick with one curve here. 4 and 10 and 16. 28, 34. It's a little bit of intersection between the gum and that shoulder pad, but I don't know if there's going to be a way that we can avoid that, so I think we'll be okay with that. What I would do that would go on usually to like a different team to polish out like that kind of stuff, which doesn't mean that we shouldn't do it, but I don't know if there's big jerk at the end, so we want to clean that up. Big jerk at the end, the name of the new Sesame Street children's book. So we'll set what we have at 12, drag it back there, which means we're going to have to lift it up a little bit more, but I still want to get some change of shape in those feet a little bit better. And we'll set that, come on, set that there. Okay, I'm sorry, okay, fine, whatever you. 4. Drag it back. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go on and we're going to work on the hands and see if we can do a little keep alive on there so they don't feel so rigid. So let's go and watch that. Now we need to raise those steps up a little bit more since we have that so that the toes aren't intersecting. Come on. So let's grab both of those feet there. And let's check out the translates. Let's even those out. And also raise them up a little bit more. And rotate X. Let's even the rotate X's out a little bit more. Okay. Let's go ahead and watch those steps a little bit better. Okay, a little bit less, and let's delay it by about 2 frames. Let's see here. These ones are a little too far out, so let's go scale that back. Okay, let's watch that now. To get too much into this hams, but let's see if we can't do a little bit there. Okay, so let's minimize that a lot. works alright. His hand still feels pretty stiff, but let's go ahead and see if we can't loosen that up by doing a little bit of finger moves. I feel like it's just the tips of the fingers for some reason. Too much, so we'll just tone it down. Set, delete, set that, delete that, set that, delete that. And that's another tip that you can do sometimes instead of getting the graph editor, just get a couple frames before, and that'll give you that similar scale down. Back a little bit more. Okay, let's watch that now. And let's scale this back a little bit more. And let's see here. There we go. Now we got a little. Still feels like it might be a little too much on the tips of the fingers. So let's scale. See, but if there's a way to get into those each individual finger, we can vary that up a little bit more, but since it's just kind of a mitt, even though there's a gap there, it makes it a little more difficult. Let's do a little bit on this hand as well. Let's actually save what we have here. scale it back a little bit more. Tips us there. A little too much. Oh, I feel like the timing's not right and my posing isn't right on there. It's just not hitting where I wanted to hit, so let's try this instead. Yeah, it feels okay. Just like I said, just a little bit of keep alive in there. Just so there's like a little bit of keep alive, so those hands feel like there's some movement throughout them. A little better. Too much movement on those fingers now. Tips. Let's watch that now. What's on this guy? Back so it feels like it's actually laying on that shoulder and not lifting off. Let's go ahead and watch that now. So there's a little bit of flappiness to this keep. And we might tone that down as well, too. But we'll see. Well, first of all, let's scale that back, because we don't need it to be a really bounce keep, just a little bit. Not really any control over the tip of that cape, is there? Not really. It's a little bit too much on that tip, and even though I know I can't see it, I can feel it a little bit, so. Let's go ahead and do a little bit of side to side here. Let's tone down that rotate Z a whole lot. Okay, let's see here. let's do a little bit of jaw open and close. Let's go ahead and turn our nerve curves off, and let's go ahead and let me change our angle just a little bit. Alright, I think that's gonna do it for today. So let me know down in the comments below any sort of thoughts, comments, critiques, concerns, things you would have done differently. If you end up doing a shot with this rig, definitely share it back so we can see all the amazing work that you guys are up to. And let's take a quick look back at where we started this afternoon and just do a couple of those. I'm not sure that all of my inspiration comes from somewhere other than my own burning desire to do art. Burning desire to do art. We didn't choose art. Art chose us, as if we were born to do art. Most artists live in their heads. Their head is filled with ideas about art and not much else. And live your art every second of your life. Never settle with your art. Continuously push yourself to do what you're sure you cannot do. Once you've mastered what you are sure you cannot master, go for it. I think that's great stuff for today. All right, folks, thanks again for liking and subscribing to the channel. You guys are amazing. I hope you have a wonderful and awesome evening tonight. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow for some more animation.